All right, so we need to make this work on desktop. Why is there so many files being deleted? What did I throw away? Just gonna put it here so I can ignore it. All right, so we just have desktop and mobile. So I'm gonna say, I think that's actually 1440. That looks too big, or too small to be 1440, right? Right? Yeah. Not with it. Yeah, that's what I thought. It's only like 700. 730-ish. Okay, so let's go to our editor and we're going to go to the app.js and give this div a max width. Max width is going to be 768, so it'd be 3XL. So go big like that, yay! And then we want to do margin auto. Oops. So now if you go to a larger screen, it should look like this, right? Yeah, max width. It's just a size that's in talent. It was 48 rem. Which is 768 pixels. Yeah, you just, this is what it looks like.
Oh, but so it's basically the same pixels.
Right. It's using rems. But yes, rems is based on the root pixel size.
Oh.
So the it's root m's. Yeah. So it'll adjust based on what your root is set at. So yeah, if I go in to here and I go to my HTML and I say font size is, let's see, this one might already, this one might be the one that's, if I say font size is 12 pixels, you'll just see how the whole thing just changed based on the font size here. So this is the 16 is like the default, so you base everything off of 16. But if somebody comes in and they set their font size a lot bigger, then my whole app will grow. And if everything is set based on rems. So sometimes that's a good thing, sometimes it's a bad thing. Some things you don't want to grow, like images, sometimes you'd want to keep the images the same size. But yeah, if I take this out, it's size of 16, so this is based on 16 pixels. So when I go look at this, it says 48, so 48 times 16 is 768. Mm-hmm. So. Cool. Cool. Yours isn't rendering. What's that on the side? Is it complaining about not knowing the image on undefined? Go to the comment form and the image of the current user. Put current user ?. Yeah, you gotta do it on the username too. Yeah. right here, and right here. Yep. All right. So now what we want to do is we want to push this off to the side on desktop. So what I'm going to do is in our, oops, that's not what I want to do. Here. In our comments.js. I didn't structure this well for this. So if I go into the card footer, I think I can say order one. Yeah, push it up. Order zero. Let's try this. If I go to the card header, wait, is card display flex? No, okay. So let's do in card, we want to set flex, which is going to break everything. Okay, then we're going to do flex column, which will fix everything. Okay, and then card footer, order zero. One. Okay, that didn't fix it. Card header. Order two. Should be order zero, I feel like. So if I do order one here, okay, and then in the card, oh, let's see, in the comments, we have this content. Now let's put that inside of a div. This is just me trying to figure out how to do this so I don't have to change the whole everything. Yeah, the whole everything. So, order one here, order zero in the card footer, and order one on the card header. Changes the order of the elements, so now the footer is the top thing. Yeah, so in Flex you can order things. So maybe what we will do though is instead of using Flex for this, we'll do grid for this and change the grid layout. So let's try that. Now I'm taking all of those out. You're welcome. Yeah, all the orders are gone. We're going to try and... It is. I just untyped it, which is not for suckers. Untyping. It's a thing. Look it up. Let's see. Grid. And then... Let's see. Doesn't Tailwind have a grid thing built in? Look at how grid works in Tailwind.
You just said something good about Tailwind. You know that.
It's good for passing but it's too much.
It made you appreciate it more.
Yeah. And it was almost like a crash course in assessing gender and everything.
Yeah. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I just want to put
my face. They actually really good, just sweet.
Yeah, it was hard.
Because these cupcakes that didn't make it sound like well, they did.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
like
yeah, if
I buy afterward, like on CLL, because I don't think we can order it with CSS, I can just type the word.
Because when I was going through this here, that wasn't called it. Just like, it explained everything so in detail. And it was so mapped out so quickly.
Right.
That's what I love about it. Because when I didn't have it, when I needed to find out something, it was just all these columns I could just go to and it just it's really top of the line. Yeah. So I was able to troubleshoot so fast. Except for overlapping.
Overlapping?
Remember when I went to overlap the planet?
Oh, yeah. I'm just trying to see if there's a good way to change the order. Change the column, we're in CSS grid. Can name stuff in grid. How do you do that in? Well, no, I don't think you can use order in grid. No, maybe. This is a flex only thing. Oh, utilities for controlling order and grid items. Flex and grid items. So maybe. And last. Minus order one. And last. So. I'm just going to play around with this for a second and see. Flex. No, because I would need to or did that seem like it did something weird? Did do something weird. Why did it do that? Oh. It's pushing this down. Oh, yeah.
Anybody want any chips? Anybody want any chips?
Can anybody click on the video?
Yeah. Yes.
Oh, you heard what
I
said.
And then I had to stop. I was like, every living.
In resources, I sent it so the timestamp was right as I asked you for the chips.
Yeah, I was like,
I thought you were joking when you said that. It was real.
What were we at?
I don't know yet. I'm still trying to figure out how to do it. Yeah, it makes it a negative one. So I have to put orders on all of these.
Oh, that's cool.
But I don't know if I want to use Flex here or not. So if I say... So I think actions, I'm going to do the same thing no matter what. So this is going to be absolute. And it's going to go to right. And then what's our padding on the card? 5. So right, 5, top 5. Should put it in a corner. So, but this is going to be medium only. This one and this one. Yeah. So you can see it move. Right there. See it pop up? Yeah, delete and edit pop up. Well, let's see. This is not in there. So let's think. I want this div to surround everything instead of having only around the one. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to move the div up and then put this in there and this in there. Move this div down. Oh, and then this has to be in a fragment. Why is it mad? Oh. There we go. That makes sense? Kind of? Yours will still be this. This will still be at the bottom, though, right? Because I didn't have you do the other stuff yet.
Come back.
Hold on. I just changed mine back to what yours is. Okay, actions. Should do that. saving properties is what they're saying. It'll only be on top when you make it larger. Okay, so I'm gonna do this hacky. Ready? Card.js. Let's see where we want it to be. Is that about the same still? Does that look like it's bigger size here than here? I guess let's look at what it looks like desktop compared to. Yeah, the padding's bigger, right? On desktop. Increases. Yeah, it's like almost double. So we say padding 10. How big is that? Yep, but we want it to be medium. So I'm gonna go here. That's big. And I'm going to make the images bigger, but we'll do that in a minute. Oops. So let's see. Put that much padding there. I'm trying to decide how hacky I want this to be. Is the height of this thing. So we're going to do the reaction. We need to have the up and down instead of side to side. So if we do flex call, then we get the up and down. So this needs to be medium. And then we'll switch the PX to be 2. And the PY to be 4. Let's see, we probably also need like items center on medium, and then make this a little bigger. 4 is great. 4. Okay, so I'm just going to do P4. Okay, which makes that. About 48 pixels. So now we get to do math. So we need, everybody caught up on this? Ish? Yes? Yes. So when you go larger, it should go like that. When you go smaller, it should look like that. What?
This has been reaction JS. I put all this in.
Yeah. These ones are in reaction.
Mm-hmm. So I wrote all my stuff from somewhere else.
Alright, so let's think. So I switched it to what? On the card. 10 on each side of that, so that's 20 plus how big is 48? Plus 20, 32. Is there 32? Yes. So this needs to be 10. And then on medium, we want PL to be, what did I have it, 32? Yeah, super hacky, ready? Super duper hacky. Hacky? Means that I'm going to now do something really dumb that I wouldn't normally do, but I don't really want to figure out how to do this. So, on the reaction card, PL32. Okay. Then in reaction, we're going to say on medium, make it absolute. I'm gonna do something really quick. You don't need to do this, it's just so I can have them wrap and then you can see them wrapping. Okay. So we're gonna do absolute. Left 10, oops, medium left 10, and medium top 10. It worked. All right, and then what we need to do is, yeah, which is really hacky, but whatever, it worked. So. Nah, it should be fine. Should be fine. Yeah, because we also probably need to have the card be relative. Yeah, we're gonna make card relative just to make sure. But it was already staying, so. These buttons need to go down just a little bit. They're not going far enough, so we'll figure that out in a second. That's based on the size of the image, so we probably want to fix the image first. And then the other thing is there's too much space down here because of the card footer. So we're going to put in a medium margin top 0. Actually, Yeah. Does this have any size now? Doesn't change anything either. Okay. So I don't need that. Alright, so yeah, it should stay where it is. Right? But now it switches off to the side. So, that fixes those issues. Everybody has that? Is there anything you need me to show you? Okay, when you pull it this way, which one doesn't look right? Okay, so you need to look at the reaction. So you need probably all of these. And you can also make this so that it's like this, and then like this. Throw this one right there. Sweet. Travis, yours works? Like this too? Mama? Christian? All looks good? Okay. I feel like this is too big now, but that's okay, we'll just leave it. And then the other thing we need is to have more space here. So this looks like maybe it's 15, 12 maybe. So on the, where was that at? Comments maybe? In the content. No, it's the comment list, huh? Comment list. This is where we have that. So we're going to say in the comment list, we want medium PL 10 and medium ML 10. Let's go up to like 12 and see what that looks like. So it's kind of off, almost in the middle of this. So let's try 15. Oh, there's not a 15, 16. Close enough. And was the border bigger? Border might be a little bit thicker on this one too. So, say medium border 2. Oops. Border dash average 2. Yeah. Did we have for the wondering if it should be one of these ones? I'm going to change this one to dash 2 and get rid of this one. And then it's that light gray. Got it? Okay. So that should make, I think that's all the differences. Oh, you know what? We need to fix the padding on this too. I feel like we did too big a padding though, but we'll just leave it that way, I guess. Because this comments form is funky looking. Well, we need to fix this reply too, so it goes down just a little bit more. Oh, this guy? Yeah. Let's change the gap on these. So if we go to actions, let's see. How are we doing a gap? Oh, we're not doing a gap. Just because the size of the buttons are big. Change this to 0, 2.5. Let's put 2. And then on primary, I'm going to do px5.
Sitting there, typing a lot of them. Oh, yeah, I could do that. Mm-hmm. And oh, oh my God, 2 minutes back. two feet tall.
Hopefully it does.
Yeah, just it go put the eyes. Can't do more than one project at a time on transition. There you go.
Okay. So you gotta move the PXs up here. In all of these. You don't need to worry about it.
Huh?
You don't have to do the ticks. I'm just doing it so you can read mine easier.
Oh, okay.
Okay, that work. And when you pull it out here, depending on the person's username, could end up still having issues, but it works okay for now. And we could fix it also by reducing this padding, which we would have to redo all the maths for. So we'll just leave it. But we need to move these down. So in actions, we're going to change the top to be 7 and see where that puts us. Go 8. Okay, 8 looks right. Okay. Kind of a hacky way to do it, but it is one way. Another thing we could do is try and figure out how to do it with grid, but I would have probably needed to worry about it earlier on so that our HTML wouldn't have to be all refactored. That's probably how I would do it if I didn't have people trying to follow along. So, okay. So, another way we can kind of fix this issue is, let's just reduce the size of these, because it's like ridiculously huge. Super huge. Let's just change it to 10 so it matches the other sizes. Oops. That's better. Alright, and then we need to fix the comment form. So it's because it's a card. So let's pass in a class name to card. And then in card, we need to accept a class name. And then we need to change this. So that it can accept. This one you do have to do the back ticks on this thing. I'm going to say last name. So now I'll do the thing I've been doing. But you do need to have the back ticks this time. Change this. I will. I haven't done anything with it yet. Okay. So yeah, you just need to add class name to yours. And then unwrap it in ticks and curly braces. Okay. And then on comment form, we want to pass in margin, or let's see, padding left 10, I think. That's right. Oh, we need it to be on medium. Medium padding left 10. Okay, that fixes it. Does it need anything else? Should be fine the way it is. Okay, so yeah. We just don't want to have that padding left be so big on this comment form. So we'll overwrite it. You saw the issue with Tailwind, right? When we were doing those buttons. Because it's cascading, right? And I had the same thing. The 2 came before the 5, and so when I was trying to override the 2 with the 5, it wouldn't work. Well, no, it was, so it was like, if I had padding left, or it was like padding X 2 and padding X 5, like that. And the 2 overrode the 5 because in the style sheet it's higher or lower, maybe, I don't know. But yeah, this one overrode this one, even though this one was second. So, something to keep in mind. What? Well, it's, so just because you're putting your class names in right here doesn't mean that it'll go in this order, I guess, is what I'm saying. Yeah, I would think that it would work, but you can see it's upset because it's like you're applying the same thing twice. So, yeah. There you go. All right, so now we need to make it so that if you hit the reply button, you get a reply box. Which was this guy. No, this one's not a model. Yeah. So, back to this view. And we're gonna go to the comments page. We're gonna add in a state of replying is, or let's say is replying, set is replying equals use state false. Did we? I don't remember doing this.
Deja vu.
Yeah, we got rid of that, right? Or no. Comment list had it. But I don't think we had an is anything. Didn't need it, I guess. I'm just doing a little bit of cleanup so that I don't have a bunch of stuff in my console. You can leave it though. It doesn't really matter. It'll still get pulled other places, or it won't get actually pulled. It'll just get referenced. Mm-hmm. All right, so what we want to do is we want to have a fragment around this card. Okay. And then underneath card, we want to put a is replying and then add another card here. And I'm just going to do some garbage in it just so we can look at it. And then our reply action will get reply click equals is replying, or set is replying true. Just look and see what this looks like. What if you decide you don't want to reply? You can't. You have to reply once you hit reply. There's no take backs. Okay. So, but that reply box looks just like our comment box. Just the only difference is it says reply instead of send. Yeah, so instead of card here, let's just do comment form. Is it called comment form? So now if we click reply, it doesn't do anything. Oh yeah, because we're not handling it. So in our actions, the reply button, we're gonna add a reply, what did I call it? Reply click. And then here on click equals reply click. Okay. Yay. There's no way to get out of it. Except for it to refresh. Alright, so now coming back to our comment form, we're gonna say action equals reply. On the comment form in comments. Okay, and then in the comment form, we're going to accept action and change this to action and we're going to default action to equal send. So, all right, so now that works. Anybody need to look at anything that I've gone past too fast? Let's see. I didn't do anything in comment list, right? No. So in comment form, we added action. We defaulted it to send, and we changed the button text to action. Okay, we're gonna probably need to add a handle submit function, but we'll do that later. And then comments. In comments, we added this line right here. And we also added this reply click. And we also added this is replying at the top. Okay, right here. And then in actions, we accepted reply click and just set it as the on click for the reply button only. Okay, I'm going to go throw this away. Right back.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
I was actually thinking, like, should I get blueberries? I was going to get the blackberries and the strawberries.
The blackberries would be gone.
But I was like, no. They'll be too spoiled. They'll be expecting it every time. I got two. Like, oh, which ones did I choose? Oh, Travis, next time make sure you get three. Okay.
Either way, you would have gone home.
Yeah, exactly.
We'll make it last two.
Exactly. Empty handed. Yeah, I love blackberries, though. Oh, my God. So addictive. They go so fast, so it's like it's almost away from them.
Mm-hmm.
Because I like
it's so good.
It's so good.
It's like $6 and you're like, aww. And like black.
And then it's like, and then it's like, but I grew up in the South, I grew up in Georgia. So those berries grow wild.
Yeah.
And it's like I said, how does it cost this much? I can go to Atlanta, just go to the little Bryant all over.
We have blackberries here too.
You do? What? Oh wow, I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm.
I like the little cherry, you know those little ones that have that beautiful shape, they're called cherry, something cherry.
Mm-hmm.
Like a mountain cherry or something.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm talking about? They're like, you know, not mountain apple, but it's the size of a cherry. And they have this really beautiful ridge, it's like, it's almost like the shape of a pumpkin, but small and red.
It's a gross one though.
I was thinking that.
Really?
It's
bitters.
Yeah.
But then some of them are bitter. I bet sweet.
I would never in my life, my grandma eat them off the tree. And, oh, it's fucking good.
Yeah.
So good. But they are beautiful.
Yes.
You think that they taste delicious.
Yeah.
My first time I ate a
so
rumbleton. My first time eating anything like the rumbleton and, you know, and like, you know, it was the rumbleton. So to see that and like, I'm like, oh my God.
Yeah.
It looks like a sea
creature,
you're like an alien, and you open them up and you're like, oh my God.
They're like these. Stringy grapes, they're so weird, but man, like I freak out over long gum and on the tons.
Yeah.
Every time I go to any farmer's market that has them, anything, I'm like, I have to.
Yeah. It's just the best.
Mm-hmm.
It's the best. It's the reason for staying on Kauai. If there's ever a reason, it's fruit.
Yeah.
And it grows wild.
Anyway.
You ever had a Colorado, have you ever had a Colorado lemon? Oh my God, that's big. Lemons in Colorado?
Mm-hmm.
They're like grapefruits.
Got it? It's working?
Yeah.
Yay! Thank you.
Lots of goodies in there.
Oh, really? Oh, he's gonna tell me that. We gotta fix that leak 5 minutes early today.
I gotta go.
I gotta go.
Alright, so everybody's is working, yes? Hit reply, you should see reply. You're not getting that?
I didn't want to hear that.
We still have a really big padding of our foot part. Oh, we have added that.
Well, yeah, I just lost there too. And I forgot.
Can
we
just,
as long
as you get
far
enough,
it's not
bad.
At the end of the last thing.
This one I did.
Yeah, right there. Next space. And then the dollar sign
passing
goes.
Do we have a button anywhere in comments too?
Button?
No, it's around 5. Okay.
Yeah, I think it was before we had that card footer. We just had a reply button and we moved it to actions.
Okay.
Alright. Ready?
Yeah, really good.
Okay, so now let's also make edit do that same thing. But edit's gonna just change this thing to be a text field and then add an update button. Okay, so in comments, we want to pass a edit click. This is going to be set is editing true. Also, based on the design, there is no way to not edit, but I guess you can just leave it the same and hit save, right? And it would essentially edit it. Okay, and then at the top, we need to create some state for is editing. Set is editing. Okay, and then comment content here. What we're going to do is we're going to say is editing, and then here will be a text area. And the value, oh, let's see, actually text areas don't have values. They have children, which would be comment.content.
So
What?
No.
The divs up here. It's around both of them. Is that what you're talking about? Yeah, but it didn't have a div around it. You should have a div around the comment content and the replying. But I don't know that we need that anymore because didn't we take the flex off of card? Yeah. So you don't need any div at all. But you can put a div around it if you want to. Oh, yeah. Actually, this is gonna. This will end up being kind of weird, but we'll look at it and see. That design doesn't make sense. Yeah, I'll show you why in a second. I mean, if you run this, you'll see why. How come it doesn't work? I thought it did. Oh, yeah, we didn't. If you go to actions, you get a handle, edit click, and then on edit, on click equals edit click. Yeah, see? Off to fix this in a second. So this is the only thing we changed on this one was we import or we accepted an edit click and we put it on the on click for the button. Yours works. Doesn't do this. Oh, let's see, where's mine? Doesn't do this.
No, mine does that. But his works. No?
But mine's on desktop.
Did you put it all around this? So this one in it too? The text area.
I'm getting the text area lines.
Right. Setting children on text area. Default value or value props instead of set. Oh, yeah. So React doesn't like that. So we can just do value equals. Can't remember if we have to do default value. So in HTML, this is how you would do a text area, but in React, it wants you to do this. But it shouldn't change how it works. In fact, it should still give me an error. Yeah. Yeah, because I didn't give it an onChange. So this needs to be default value. Should work the same way, but. Yours doesn't have the username over here?
No, I don't know why.
Does it have the username normally?
Yeah.
Oh, it's on top?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. That doesn't, I mean, it's basically the same thing. Do you have a div here? Mine still does the same thing though, even if I don't have the div. You probably have, do you have Flex still in your card? If you go to your card, do you see Flex? Yeah. I don't have Flex or Flex Column. I don't have Flex Call.
I got rid of Flex.
You have Grid in there? Yeah, I don't know. I'll have to fix that anyway, so. What I was going to do is here, say, and not is editing, and then that would hide that anyway. Okay. Weird. And you didn't have the div? Yeah, but you don't actually need it because we're not doing anything with the.
So, what did you do to fix the.
I just set.
What did you do under actions? There's something that missing down here.
That should be a
close div.
Instead of a colon after you edit it.
And then you close up.
Yeah.
My div is going to close div somewhere down there, right? Mm. Oh, no, it's close.
Close was up there.
Yeah, gotcha. Okay. That was what
I'm doing. Maybe scroll up. Maybe something else on fire.
Something must be missing, that's all.
Something's broken.
Yeah,
somewhere.
Something's missing. But I'll give it. Okay.
Okay, so then also this text area, let's throw a class name on it. If we look at the comment form, I'm just going to take whatever class name we have for the comment form. So it's the same. We don't need flex grow because it's not in a flex. But we'll do the borders and the rounded and the paddings. And then I'm going to do width full. And then I'm going to say min height is 5 maybe. That one. Fit? Nah, that's not what we want. Put the full, and then let's just say, is it columns? Rows. Set rows to 3, 4. We can do the same thing in the comment form. Set the rows on there. Make it a little taller.
if you put such row back?
No. Text areas take a rows, which will tell you how tall it will be. So
can
rows of text. What?
Can you go beyond that if the, or does that act kind of like a character?
No. It can go beyond it, you just will scroll. But you can grab this thing and stretch it.
Is that just common text area?
What?
Is that just common text area?
Okay, so we also need in the comments with this text area, let's throw it inside of a fragment. Because we need to have a button. Let's see, what does the design look like? Oh. Okay, so this is it, push the button underneath, so just like I wanted. So, button. Now we do have a button in comments. Now that we just got rid of it. Update, and the variant on this button is primary. And then we want to last name equals, is there floats? Float right. That's dumb. Didn't work. So let's do just gonna make this a div. Add a class name here of flex, and then put flex call, and then this, I'm going to say justify items in. And then gap is going to be 2, 4. No class name of the button. Okay. This is done. Yeah, so I guess this should be a form instead of a div, and then this should be on submit, and we'll say at the top here const handle reply. Form submit event, prevent the default. And in here we can say set is replying to false. And set this on submit to handle reply. Actually, this shouldn't be handle reply, it should be handle edit. Rename. And handle edit to false. Editing. So. Yeah. On submit on the form handle edit. Okay. Very nice. So, down?
Yes.
Got it? Everybody? Yeah? Good? Okay. So, the only other one is delete. When delete gets clicked, we need to pop up a modal. Obviously, these don't work yet, right? Like, hit send, it doesn't do anything here. But because right now what we're doing is we're getting that from a JSON file, we don't have a way to really update it, so we can work on that in a little bit. But right now we're showing all the UI. The next thing we want to do is create a modal. So we're going to create a new component called modal. Delete, no, cancel. What's the modal effect here? Exactly the same. Maybe a little bit smaller text. Nah, smaller. Nah, it's the same thing. It's exactly the same. Does it? It looks like the buttons are bigger on mobile. Like taller. And like the side padding is smaller.
Yeah, but the buttons are smaller on mobile.
They're taller, but they're not as wide. And then the header looks like it's slightly smaller too.
Yeah.
Sometimes when a designer sends you something like that, you just don't do it.
I would also be like, no, I have formatting purposes.
Alright, so we're gonna make a div here. we're gonna say we'll pull that from state. We'll put the modal in Redux so that you can see how to create a slice. Okay, so what we'll do here is we'll say we'll just create the modal straight here. So header is going to be delete comment, and then we'll have a paragraph here that says, are you sure you want to delete this comment? If I open this, can I copy that? We'll remove the comment and can't be undone. And then there should be a div here. Button. Variant is primary. So yes, delete. Except for these aren't both primary, neither of them are. These are new ones. Why would you say no and yes? What does it say delete and cancel? Yeah, this is dumb. And then I was gonna say this should be secondary, and then I'm gonna do danger inverse, inverse like this. And I'll show you how we're gonna handle that in a second. And okay, so class name on the div is going to be position, let's see, let's say fixed. We're going to say flex. Let's see, top 0, left 0, right 0, bottom 0, flex, justify, center, and items, center. I think we want to throw a div here, so we don't have to worry about messing all of this up. Okay, so now if we do, let's go to app.js and put modal into it. Okay, just like we hoped for. Okay, so now we want to do modal.js background. Do black, and then capacity. I'm gonna go 20%. I'm gonna go 60%. Okay. And then on this div, we're gonna add a class name and say background is white. Actually, this could be a card. Yes. I love it when a plan comes together. What does card header do? Can't remember. Perfect. Except for add some classes around that. And this needs to be flex. Max width. Let's say small. Justify end. I'm not going to do the inverse, I'm just going to do danger dash inverse. Take the variant off of cancel. Nope. That's done. Okay. So if we go to button, we need to add a danger inverse, which will be background text white. Okay. It's not working. This makes it so you can't see it. Here's my modal. Let me throw this here. What's off to the right?
The text.
There's like basically a bunch of padding off to the corner.
Yeah.
Over here?
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, is it on medium?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so I think what we need to do is we need to change which one we're doing that on. So let's go to the card.js and let's delete this medium thing here. Yeah, just cut that. And then let's go to the, which one do we need that for? It was for the comments, right? So this card right here, add class name there, and put that in that one. And then we can take that out of the comment form as well. You don't need the class name on the card in the comment form anymore? You only need to add it to the comments one? Can't remember. Yeah. Then we don't have to remember that every time. Card shouldn't automatically go left. What? All the way to the right? Mine's in mobile though. It's because the size of the padding is big. So you could, on the modal, we could just say medium padding. Let's set it to like 6 or maybe 8 so that it's a little bit smaller. Let's go 7. Because remember I said it's kind of ridiculous how big this is, but I didn't want to deal with having to re-figure this out. So. Okay. We could even just keep it at 5, because it didn't really look like in the design it changed the padding around the card that much, if at all. So then the other thing we need to do is open the card header and accept a class name here. And then change this one to accept a class name. Okay. That is so we can change this text. Oh, let's see. That's just a header. Yeah, that's it. Okay. So now what we want to do is in our card header, let's say class name equals text. I don't know which, it's the moderate blue? Is that what that looked like in the? No. It's just like, it's gray of some sort. No, it looks darker than all those. What other colors do we have? Tailwind, config, dark blue maybe? Where's the dark blue? Yeah, that one. And then we're going to say font medium, and text large, extra large. So we'll say text large, and then on medium, text extra large. And then not use the card header here. Sorry. I don't like that it's too much. Just change it to header. And then do a margin bottom 2, 4, 3. Yes, 3. Shouldn't change anything else though. And what size is our text? Text is fine, except for I think that this needs to be like the that looks fine. So let's add a gap on the buttons of 2, so they're spread out just a little bit. That does it for our modal. And we can delete this import. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to go create a in app, or let's see, features, we're going to create a new file called modal slice.js, and then in modal slice we will do a import of create slice. Yeah, in features, modal slice.js. Okay, and then we're going to say initial state, const initial state equals is open false. Current comment ID null. Okay. And then we'll say const modal slice is equal to create slice. Name is modal. State, and then reducers, which is a function. It's an object like that. Is that right? Just make sure. Okay, and then I think if we do I think we can just name our reducer, so like handle open, handle, let's say handle modal open, which is a function that gets state and action. And it's gonna, I guess we only need state here. We're gonna say state dot is open equals true. And then we're gonna export default modal slice dot reducer. And above that we're gonna say export const equals modal slice dot actions. We should have handle mode open. Careful.
Just my liquor. I'll break that glass.
Everybody got this?
Yeah.
Slice good? Okay. So now in App Store, we need to add a reducer, which is going to be the modal. And then we're going to import modal reducer from features modal slice. And this will be modal reducer. Which one? This?
Yeah.
Or just the slice?
Slice away.
Yes. Yes. So I'll show you why we're doing it in a second. It'll become more clear. But this is not that much different than just a use state, right? We just have some state that we give to the reducer. And handle modal open is going to have state is open. We'll have a handle modal closed, which is going to do state dot is closed or is open equals false. And we'll pull that into handle modal closed right there. And we're going to also take on the modal open, I'm going to take an action, and from that action, I'm going to get the comment ID. So I'll say current or state dot current comment ID equals action dot payload. And then on close, I'm going to clear that comment ID. So set it back to null. Okay, so as far as the store goes, this is just registering the modal reducer into the reducers. If you go look at your Redux now in here, all this part did was add modal, which is our initial state here. Okay. This just exports our functions that we're creating inside this reducer, the actions here. So a modal slice contains like the actions and the reducer and a whole bunch of other little things. The store just cares about the reducer. So we pull in the reducer because we exported that as default, right? And then in modal, what we're going to do is we're going to select from here. So we'll say const is open. Actually, we can just have this be is open because it doesn't matter. Equals use selector, and this will get state. And we're going to say state dot modal dot is open. Okay. And then we're going to say in this class name stuff, we're going to remember that CLSX that we had. We're going to import CLSX from CLSX. And inside here, we're going to say we're going to go CLSX this around our string here, and then we're going to put display. Just a none somewhere. So we're like hide. Yes. Okay, and then take out flex. And what we want to do is a comma, an object, and here we're going to say flex, and that is open. Okay, so modal only cares about whether or not it's open, and we're going to have the delete button do the other part. Yeah, so flex will be, if is open is true, then flex will be the class name that is applied. Okay. So, what we want to do now is in our actions.js, we have this delete button. So we're going to use const dispatch equals use dispatch, And then we're also going to, so we'll say handle or const handle delete. This is going to dispatch handle modal open. Yeah, dispatch is what sends it to React or to Redux. Dispatches this action, and then we need to get a ID for this comment, which I think the comments had IDs. So we need to open up comments. And in the actions, we need to add a ID, a comment ID equals comment.id. And then in the actions, we're going to accept that comment ID. And we're going to pass it here. And then the delete button needs an onClick, which will be handle delete. What? Yes. Yes, it's up here. What, the comment ID? Should be a prop. You should pass it through on comments. Like this. In the actions. And trying to see why that's not dispatching. Four. Handle modal open. State modal is open is true. But the modal doesn't show up. So that's working. CLSX is not passing the right class name. Let's look at the elements. Oh, it does have flex. How come flex isn't working? Aha. See? See? Stupid. Alright, so in our modal, we need to have hidden, not is open. And then get rid of hidden up here. Yes. So now, just in that object. Okay, so now if you hit delete, this will show up. And then we want to, in modal, we want to get dispatch as well. Cancel dispatch. Handle model closed. And we'll put that on the on click on the cancel. Handle cancel. So now closed. Okay, what did you want? My modal says?
It's not in together brackets. It's the default.
Push somebody.
Because
that's what that means, like when a little pop-up page is what came right out.
Ingredients and it's like fresh ingredients. And I'm
call it, they call it a Dahmer recipe. Eat the pie. The time is over.
So it should be whatever you call it in your mole, yes. Or sorry, in your mole slice.
Oh, yes, it's in the mole slice.
So go back to your
mole,
yes.
Inside of dispatch and the outside handle of the mold.
Okay, I guess I'm going to be the third one then. You can't ever keep in tone.
And then go to your actions.
Doggy bones on it. Doggy
truth.
Just go to the top. Oh, okay. So if that's doggy truth, you can go to the top.
Okay, so that
I look at it as a bone.
So now if you go.
Oh, my first goal.
Cancel. So go to your
actions.
Oh, sorry, mole. Oh, you gotta call it, sorry. Just add the turns.
Thanks.
Sweet. Yes, you got it?
Oh, okay.
You're okay?
Mm-hmm. Don't worry. I have things to clean up. But I'll do it tonight.
Okay, so what questions do you have about the slice?
It's not a question, but it's starting to look back to
how many slices can I get out of this slice?
I guess I'm going to guess, like, what is kind of the anatomy of the slice? How do we decide? I guess the mobile slice is like the main actions that are going to happen with the mobile. Makes sense.
Right. Yeah. So, and if you had other things that you wanted to track, you could create slices for those, right? So this one is just going to handle the modal. We would also probably add a function here for if you hit delete. Okay, so we have the current comment ID. And then we could have, if you clicked delete, an API endpoint that we hit and use that current comment ID to, you know, delete it. So if we had handle delete in here, or handle delete comment or something like that, right? Then this one could do whatever API stuff. But really, this wouldn't be here. There'd be a different thunk, which we would do up here. So const handle mobile, or handle delete comment would be here, which would be a function that was, let's see, I think it's create async thunk. And then this takes a string and a payload creator. So this would be, thunk is like a async function. So these are supposed to be synchronous, right? They're just supposed to change the state and that's all they do. This is going to be an async one. So we would say like delete comment, something like that. We could even have it be hyphenated, but and then this would take state and action here. We wouldn't really need an action because we already have access to the state. So then here we'd be like fetch API, and then method is delete. And body is json.stringify comment ID state.current comment ID. Okay, so if we had like a fetch that could go out and hit slash with delete and get and then give it this object that has the comment ID, then that endpoint would delete the comment, right? And this thunk, we'd just export this, export const, okay?
So this goes back to the
yeah, so instead of fetch, I'm just gonna say console.log, okay? And then what will happen in here is when I dispatch that, so if I go to my modal, I can say const handle delete equals dispatch handle delete modal comment, call it, and then on my delete button, I could add a onClick is handle delete. Now if I go and click, well, if I hit delete and then I go to my console and I hit delete here, let's look at Redux. Okay, because it is a async function, it's expecting to get a promise back. Okay, so fetch would automatically send that promise back, right? So what we would need to do is we need to fake the fetch. But I mean, if we change this to a fetch and then I hit, sorry, delete, and then I'm gonna just commit all this so we can just see the delete. and I get pending and then rejected because I can't do that, right? If I go to my network, it doesn't know how to fetch that. Let's see, it needs to return. Cannot read properties of undefined reading current comment ID. I thought this took a state. Let's look up create action. Let's see. State. Actually,
small satisfaction.
What's in the options? I don't know, that's not me. Thumb KPI. Argument thumb KPI. Okay, so this would be arg, and then this would be get state. I think we can probably just pull get state from there, like that. So then we would do around the fetch, we'd need to put that back up, and then just do return. And we'd say const state equals get state, and now state should do that. Structure property get state is ref as it is undefined. What? Code creator function will be called two arguments. Arg is single value containing the first parameter is passed to the func action. For passing, if you need to pass multiple actions together, an object may specify something like this. So. Yeah, there we go. Okay, so you do have to give it a dummy argument even though you're not going to use it. And then you can get state like this. And then, because this isn't connected to the store, or it's not connected to this slice, so it doesn't give you that state. Okay, so this is how you'd create like a async function. We could hit our API with this. Now we have the API service as well, right? So we could just use that to make all of our modifications because it's already hooked up to our API. So that might be where we actually want to look, and then just pull the state from the modal slice when we're ready to delete. But there's multiple ways to use slices and services and that kind of stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So I wanted to give you an example of these. So so if I refresh, is it executing so many queries? All right, so now if I hit delete, it should pop this up, and I hit go, I get the pending, and then I get the fulfilled. Okay. So, if I look at my network, it's actually a 404, so came back with cannot hit delete, or can't delete on that, which is fine. But because it wasn't a 500, I didn't get the, it didn't reject. So I could probably say, this be async, and we can say const result equals, and then res dot if not res. Okay, throw new error res dot status. Why is it trying to do that? I'm getting an error. Status text. Status error. Okay. And if we look in our Redux now, still was fulfilled because it was, because it doesn't actually, it doesn't actually return an error. It just returned the 404. So, yeah. So we are getting these, and then you can watch for those in the extra reducers. Right. So this would allow us to say like build what the thing is, but you can watch those, you can watch for these like delete things that are coming through, depending on the fulfilled in this extra reducers. So and all of that can be seen in their docs. So you have builder, builder.add case, doesn't really matter what you call this, it's just a param. So build.add case, and then you would have the case be the name of this function, which was handle delete comment dot, and then fulfilled, and then this is state action, so whatever comes back from it, and then you'd have one for pending and one for rejected. So that way you could handle whatever happens with that async with your state, so and still handle closing the modal here or removing that comment from the list if that was what you needed to do, or tell it to go re-update and get the comments again. So it's okay, it was recorded. Okay.
Yep.
Sweet.
I think next time we're going to do more work, we're going to the slice.
Yep.
Slice away.
Just kind of like, and we're like, okay, this was this, this pushes this.
Yep.
Cool push.
Absolutely.